So guys, we understood the introduction part of our redemption of franchise. Now, let us understand what are the genuine risks which we require to pass. See, I will give you all the journal entries. See, what is the first journal entry we pass is when calls in arrears received. See, if any calls in arrears money is pending and if the company is receiving any calls in arrears money, then we need to pass an entry called as bank account debit to calls in arrears account. Calls in arrears account. So debit credit. So this is the first journal entry we need to make. And what is the second situation which we require to pass the journal entry is, if suppose if 100 rupees is the face value of the preference share and if the company is called up to 90 rupees and remaining 10 rupees they did not call till the end of the tenure of the preference share capital. So at the time of payment of preference share, redeemable preference share capital, the company need to call the final call amount and assume that the company has made a final call and they have received all the entire final call money. See, for any call money, we need to pass two journal entries showing first final call money as due and then we have received it as usual. Okay. Now, what entry we can pass is redeemable preference share final call account debit to redeemable preference share capital account showing the amount is due. Showing the amount is due. Once if you pass this, then what is the second entry we pass? Okay, I will write the heading. This is the first situation. The second situation is call money made and received. So that you will understand easily, call money made and received. So for this, what is the first journal entry we give is redeemable preference share final call account debit to redeemable preference share capital account amount debit credit. This is the first entry we give for the call money received. Second one is bank account debit to redeemable preference share final call account. See, here we first up we shown that preference share final call money is due and then preference share final call money we have received. Once if you done with this, check in the this thing and adjustments, if any investments have been sold, if any investments are sold, then we take bank account debit, I leave little space here, to investment account. Say for example, if you sold investment of 1 lakh worth of investment for 1 lakh rupees, there is no profit, no loss, because we are selling 1 lakh of investment for 1 lakh. So we are receiving cash, cash is coming in and investment is going out. So bank account debit to investment account. What happens if the investment cost rupees 1 lakh but you sold it for 90,000 rupees, you get 10,000 rupees of loss. That loss entry we have to show it here. So then I will show it here as loss on sale account debit. I will show it as a 10,000. Now we sold it for 90,000. We got 10,000 rupees of loss and total investment gone is 1 lakh rupees. Am I right? Suppose if 1 lakh rupees cost of investment, if you sold it for 1 lakh 5,000 rupees, then when you sell an investment cost of 1 lakh for 1 lakh 5,000, how much cash you receive is 1 lakh 5,000 That time you will not have any loss on sale of investment. You will receive 1,05,000 rupees of cash, and investment cost is going out from the company is 1 lakh, and the remaining will be profit on sale. Profit on sale, I will write it as 5 rupees. That means if you get a loss, show the debit entry. If you get a profit, show it as a credit entry. So this is how we need to pass the entries for sale of investment, either for profit or loss. Next is, if you are going for fresh issue of shares, when you are going for fresh issue of shares, then what is the for fresh issue? Generally we pass 2 general entries. One is bank account debit. So here I'll mention fresh issue of shares. Fresh issue of shares. When you are going for issue of shares freshly, then in this 2 entries will come. One is bank account debit, 2 share application account. Bank account debit to share application account, showing that share application amount is due or received. Once if you receive the share application money for share capital, then we need to transfer share application to share capital. So second entry we pass is share application account debit to share capital account. Suppose if you are issuing at premium, if you are issuing at premium, say for example 10 rupees share or 10 rupees share you are issuing it for 12 rupees, for 2 rupees as a premium, then here in the first journal entry you will write it as 12 rupees amount you received as a share application. In this share application 12 rupees, 10 rupees is towards the share capital and remaining 2 rupees will be the security premium. Understood guys? So this is how we need to pass. It may be like even for the discount also. If 10 rupees share is issued for 8 rupees, then we show here bank account debit 8 rupees, 8 rupees, and share application amount we show it as 8 rupees, and discount on issue 2 rupees, and share capital will be remain same as 10 rupees. So I don't think you become students will get such a very good questions. Okay. So this is for fresh issue of shares. Okay. After this, as I explained you in the legal aspect, we have to arrange for payment of capital portion of the preference share. Right. So we have to arrange. So how do we need to arrange? I will write for journal entries for arrangement of redemption of preference share capital. So, how can I arrange? I can use all the divisible profits. Am I right? So, I can use all divisible profits which I explained you, like general reserve, reserve fund, right? Surplus, insurance fund, dividend equalization fund, insurance fund, employees compensation fund, all these put together, how much you are utilizing it for payment of redemption capital, that need to be transferred to where? To the capital redemption reserve. Am I right? Capital redemption reserve. Sir, this is the very, very important journal entry which we have to pass in all the problems. Because when you want to pay for capital portion of preferential capital, we must ensure the arrange from the profits earned by the company. Okay. So therefore, all divisible profits. I am writing it as a all divisible profits. Suppose if in the question, if you are using 5 lakh rupees as a general reserve, 2 lakh rupees as a profit and loss account, 1 lakh rupees as a dividend equalization reserve, then you can write all the three and then debt to capital reduction reserve or capital redemption reserve. After once if you arrange for the capital portion of the preference share capital, then next is we need to arrange for payment of redemption premium. for the payment of redemption premium. So as I told you, when you are arranging it for payment of redemption premium, we can go for security premium as an option. Security premium debit. If security premium is not sufficient, then we will go for divisible profits debit to, what is that, redemption premium account. So debit here, credit. Sir, once if you arrange it for capital portion and redemption portion, your maximum entries are over. Now we need to transfer the share capital to the shareholders account, showing the share preference share capital amount which we are due to the shareholders. Now what is that, showing due for preference share holders. So how do you write this? Is redeemable preference share capital account debit. If you are paying on premium, then premium on redemption account debit to redeemable preference share holders account. So this we are showing that so much of amount we are due to the preference share holders. Suppose if you are paying for capital portion as 10 lakhs and 1 lakh rupees as a redemption premium, we have to show that total 11 lakh rupees is due or payable to the redeemable preference share holders. Once if you show that it is due, final last entry is payment of, what is this? Payment to redeemable preference share holders. Then once if you pay, what happens? Your debit, the credit entry, redeemable preference share holders account debit to bank account. Okay guys, so this is the final entry which we need to pass. Now totally, if in a problem, if all scenarios are given, if all the adjustments are given, then definitely there won't be call scenarios. Either call scenarios will be there or call made will be there. So if you have call scenarios, then these two entries will, you can skip 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 journal entries which we need to pass. Now what happens if in the question, if he says that issue the bonus share to the existing equity shareholders. So for issue of bonus shares, I told you when you can issue the bonus, say this is also a rule or a provision under section 55 of the Companies Act of 2013. Say bonus issue you can make only using the capital redemption reserve. Capital redemption reserve. If the capital redemption reserve is not sufficient, then we can utilize the security premium, or else we can use out of profits also. So that means in order to issue bonus shares to the existing shareholders, you can arrange for the bonus issue utilizing the capital redemption reserve. If capital redemption reserve is not sufficient, then you can utilize the security premium available in the company, or out of profits, or all types of divisible profits also you can utilize for the payment of bonus issue. Now let us know what is the journal entry which we pass for bonus issue. So first I will write here as issue of bonus shares. So bonus share first entry will be like capital redemption reserve account debit to bonus issue account. to bonus issue account.
So that means to say we are using this capital redemption reserve, where is capital redemption reserve for the payment of bonus issue. Okay,
and last entry is bonus issue account debit to share capital account. Okay guys,
this is the last
journal entry. So totally we need to pass
10 journal entries if all scenarios are given in the question. So please make a note of all these journal entries and which we need to learn while solving the problems. Okay, and if you have any questions, please put it in the comment box so that I can give you the reply.